In this video, we're going to take a look at a really cool feature of GitHub, which is GitHub Actions, and how you can add them to your project. The idea of continuous integration and deployment is becoming an increasingly more important part, especially for data engineers. And Actions allow you to have workflows to automate that process. So here we are in the project, and I've gone over to the Actions tab. And here it gives you a lot of information. At a high level, understand that actions are what's going to allow you to automate certain scripts, testing, deployment, things like that. And all of this is handled through GitHub workflow files. What we're going to do is just click set up this workflow. And what this is going to do is within your project, within the GitHub directory, .github, if you already have it, it's putting it within a new workflows directory, and it's just called blank.yaml. Obviously, that's not what you want to keep. We'll change this to something else. In this case, let's call it ci.yaml. This can be a little overwhelming at first when you see it. It might seem super confusing, especially if you're not used to YAML syntax or Linux scripting or any of that stuff. But I promise you, once you get the hang of it, you start to really pick up what's happening, and it's just a matter of kind of finding and replacing things. So let's walk through the syntax briefly on what we're even looking at. From the top here, this is saying, on. So when will this action run? When is this workflow going to be triggered? The default here is saying on a push to this branch, on a pull request against main. And these are things that you can edit as much as or a little as you want. It's totally up to you. They're just putting some defaults in here. Down here, it's also saying on workflow dispatch, meaning you can run it manually. And we'll see what that looks like a little bit later. A workflow is made up of one or more jobs. This right here is the job. So the top here is saying, when will we run this? And this is saying, what will we run? So we have one job here called build. What will this run on? Ubuntu latest. And this might be a little confusing as well if you're not used to Linux. This is a Linux operating system. And essentially what's gonna happen here is behind the scenes, GitHub, through this feature of Actions, is going to spin up a virtual machine or a container. I think it's a container that is using this operating system. You can change this to something else. I think you can choose Windows or Mac, and everything that follows is operating on that machine. So you can almost think about it, it's as though you've went to AWS or Azure and went in and made a virtual machine and tried to run something, but instead this is doing it for you. And the idea is that every time this runs, it's going to be a fresh build so that you're sure that what you're testing is consistent every single time. And then the steps are the next part, uses, actions.checkout/checkout. We'll touch on this in a minute. This is referring to kind of a pre-packaged set of things that are going to happen. And all this is saying is it's going to check out and essentially use the files and the directories of whatever branch you're currently on. And then we have these next two ones, which are just simple run commands. And run, as it says, is going to use the runner's shell. And in our case, we're using a Linux shell. So this would be bash, so that you can assume that this would be the equivalent of opening up a bash terminal and running something. Echo hello world. Here you can run a couple scripts in a row. And to simplify, I'm gonna take out all of these comments. When you get rid of all of those comments, it's actually only a couple lines, and that's something we can work with. So I'm going to start a commit. Let's just get this built onto our main branch, and then we can see it actually run. Commit new file. So now this is there. And remember, we did say anything pushed to master will trigger it. So if we go to actions now, here we can see it's running this workflow on the push to master. This was the name of the commit that we had. We see CI, that's the name of the workflow that we gave it. And if we go in here, there's only one job, that job build. And here are each of the steps. By default, there are a couple of things that happens. It sets up the job and completes. Then we have this run actions. This is that checkout action we talked about. It's gonna run a one line script, just that hello world, again, just from that Linux bash command. This comes built in with a post run that is going to close this out. So all this stuff now set up automatically for us to run. Before we get into actually editing this a little bit, I want to show you some of the documentation and where that lives and touch on some things that we were looking at before. So I've opened up a few links here. Here's the docs for GitHub Actions. There's a lot of information here. You can, honestly, in my opinion, learning GitHub Actions is not something that you can just read and you'll just understand it. You really have to play around with it and run some of your own tests and examples, get the hang of what's happening and see your way through it. So a popular link here is the workflow syntax. And this, again, this is a lot of information at first, and it can seem intimidating, but really it's more of a reference. So as you start to run into different scenarios and you're like, okay, how do I do this type of action or this command? You can look through here and read through it and try to find what you need. For example, this on command, we said on push to branches main, you know, for example. We don't have to specify the branch. They're saying you can add a list. You can exclude certain things and ignore certain branches or tags. It's really customizable and all this stuff is here if you need it. The other item I want to touch on real quick is this uses actions checkout. I remember when I started, this was really confusing. What does this even mean? What are we talking about here? And what this is it's referring to this right here, github.com/actions. These are publicly available actions that you can use. For example, we're using checkout v2. And if you were to look up checkout, action for checking out a repo, this is a very popular one. So really what you're doing is inheriting a project and using some of its files. Here we can see usage, and within here it'll give you some more specific on how you can do different things with it, customize it how you want. Maybe you only want to check out a specific branch every time, you know, up to you, but all that information is available here. Let's go into our project here. I'm going to do a git pull so that I now have this new workflow file in here. So first what I'm going to do is I'm going to edit a little bit of this. So instead of working with branch main here, let's delete this. Now I'm going to do on push to test CI. I'm going to do that because what I'm also going to do is git checkout test CI. So now if we look at our branch, this is what we're doing. And what I'm saying here is only run this when there's a push to this branch. We'll also have the ability to do it manually if we want. I'll just keep that there. Let's add another step here. For example, let's just say we want to add run another script, and the name is what will come up in our workflow, and we'll just say echo, this is a new command, just get this pushed through and push this to our remote branch. And now if we go back to actions, we can see this automatically picked it up because within the file it's saying look out for this scenario, and that scenario happened. So now if we go in here, it succeeded, so it ran all these things, and we can see this new step that we added, run another script. This is a new command and it ran successfully. Now what I want to do is take it another step forward and start to incorporate of that third party GitHub action that we can reference. And the scenario that I'd like to play out here is we're going to create a Python script that creates a new file. But in order to do that, we need to first install Python onto our virtual machine. You got to think of it as that virtual machine that's spinning up. It's a blank slate. So we need to make sure we specifically say everything that we want to put on it. So let's look for Python. Here we see setup Python usage. See, it's similar to the checkout. What we'll do is we'll add a step that's to install Python. So I'm going to put this side by side here so we can see. I'm going to get rid of these guys here. Let's do a few things first and let's see if we start to follow along here. I know I'm moving a little quick, but hopefully this will make sense. Let's list all files. And instead of an echo, we'll just run ls. So imagine it's going to run ls in the bash command in the context of this repo. That's where you are. So we would expect it to list all these files, and we'd only expect to see these two. So I'm actually going to also create a new Python file called createfile.py. And really what I want to do is, so we're going to list all files, create a new file, and then list the files again. But first, we also need to install Python. So we're install Python, create a new file, and then list the files again to prove that Python worked. So to create this file, I'm going to just copy and paste this in here. It's essentially just a quick script to create a new file, but let's rename this and call this something more interesting. So this file is available for us. Obviously we haven't checked it in yet. What we want to do is list the files. So we'll actually see these three first. Next, let's add a step to install Python. And what we'll do is copy this right here, indentation right. And what this is saying is the name of the step is this. We're going to use this project, this action. And one of the options we have here is with, and we can identify the version. We'll do 3.8. So it's saying install Python version 3.8. We're going to list the files, install Python 3.8, and then let's run a Python script. You can use this command with the next step, run Python my script, just like you would locally. But instead of my script, we're going to do create file.py. And we would expect that file to create a new file at the end, list the files again so we can see the new files. And we would expect this new one to now show up. We'll say list all original files, install Python, run the Python script, and then list the files to confirm they're there. And hopefully that made sense. And again, all of this is going to happen on this virtual machine here, this runner machine, which is Ubuntu latest. And this is only ever going to happen when we push to this branch, which we're about to do shortly. Let's go ahead and add this now. Git push. Let's go to actions now. And now we can see it's running again. And if we go into here, let's go to build. So here that ran very quickly. If we go to the list, we can see these files, the readme and create file. Now we've installed Python onto this runner. It's going to run that script. We can see kind of where that's happening. So by that point, it would have created that new file because that's what the script did. It ran that script in that directory. Now let's list the new ones. And here we can see it now built that new file for us in that same directory. We don't see it here because obviously we didn't run that script here, but we ran it on the runner machine and here it is for us. And now it'll just run this post action and close it out for us. So like I said, that is just a brief intro on what you can expect and how GitHub Actions work. And as more projects move towards version control and being in code, it gives you more flexibility to automate so many different things. I hope this was helpful. If you did find it helpful, feel free to like, subscribe if you want to see more videos. We'll upload every week, and I'll see you with the next video. Thanks for watching.